Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you in the video lecture on the subject Design of Transmission Systems. And this is lecture number 4.1. We are going to discuss the design of wire ropes. And in the earlier lecture, we discussed the design of flat belt, V-belt, chain drive using the PSG design data book. And in this lecture, we will be discussing the design of hoisting wire ropes and pulleys. The learning outcome to the students at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to design wire rope using the PSG design data book. Wire ropes, they are popularly used for hoisting purpose. The wire ropes are flexible element for the power transmission, specifically used for hoisting and the hauling process. Particularly in the material handling operation for lifting all the cranes, we are using the wire ropes. The material used for the wire ropes: wrought iron, cast steel, copper, bronze, and the stainless steel. And the wire rope will look like this. So we have a core wire, and we have number of wires wound around the core wire, and this is the wire rope total. The construction is called as wire rope, and this is one particular strand. So each strand will have the central wire, and around the central wire there will be more number of wire, and this is a single wire. So the single wire wound around the strand, number of strand comprises the entire wire rope. So there will be more number of strands, 6 strands and 19 wires or 37 wires. So like that the construction varies. So the central core, this is the entire wire rope. We have a central core. Around the central core we have number of strands. In each strand there is a central wire. Around the central wire we have more number of wires. So this is the construction or the cross section of a wire rope. And how the wire ropes are designated? So there are different types of different method: 6x7 rope, 6x19 rope, and 6x37 rope. So wire ropes are designated by the number of wires in each strand and number of strand, its diameter, its construction, and the grade. 6x7, there are 6 strands. So this is the core. We have 6 strands, and each strand you find number of wires, 7 numbers of wires. So this is one strand, second strand, third, fourth, fifth, sixth strand, and each strand we have 7 wires. So 6x7. 6x19. So there are again 6 strands, and each strand there are 16 wires. So this is 6x19 construction, and this is 6x37. So 6 strands are here, and each strand there are 37 wires. So these are all the 3 popular types of wire ropes used in the material handling operation. And what do you mean by 6x19? So 6 is the number of strand and 19 is the number of wire in each strand. So this is what the 6x19 construction. So each strand will have 19 wires. So there are 9 wires on the outer circle, and again 9 wires on the inner circle, and there is 1 wire at the center. So this is 6x19. And there is another way of writing designate the wire. So 6x12/6/1, where the first 6 stands for number of strands, and 12 stands for 12 wire over the 6 wires. So here we have simple construction: 1 wire over the 1 wire we have 9 wires, another 9 wires on the outer periphery. Now here 12 wires over the 6 wires, and 6 wires over the core wire. So core wire and the 6 wires around the core wire, and 12 wires around the 6 wire. That is what the 6x12/6/1. But here it is 6x19. The 19 may be written as 9/9/1. So first 9, second 9, and center there is 1. The advantages of wire ropes: smooth, steady, and silent operation. Unlike the flat belt or the chain drive, so it is very smooth, and the load carrying capacity is also high. the misalignment of the shaft is permitted to some extent. So whereas the misalignment will lead to efficiency, lower efficiency of the drive in the case of belt or the chain drive. So here we can admit, we can allow misalignment of the shaft to some extent. Large amount of power can be transmitted in any direction using the wire rope transmission system. We can transmit large amount of power. Coefficient of friction is higher than the belt drive. Low cost of insulation and high efficiency. As the rope are elastic, rope drives are subject to fewer shock. So the shock absorbing capacity is also more in the case of wire ropes. The disadvantages of wire ropes: power loss due to the slip. There is a possibility of slip. Whereas in the chain drive or the V-belt drive, the possibility of slip is negligible. Occupies more space. The frequent adjustment of the center distance is required. High wear rate and the high initial cost. So the cost of the arrangement, the entire setup of the wire rope system, wire drive system is costly. The application of wire rope drive used in the mines, tramway, power transmission, used in the hoisting equipment like cranes and the elevator. So all the material handling equipment, we are using the wire rope drives. So the design procedure of the wire ropes using the PSD design data book. The equations are available in the chapter 9 of the PSD design data book. Using the chapter 9, we can design the wire rope. So from the given problem, note down the weight to be lifted, lifting speed and acceleration, etc. Select the group of wire, generally 6x19 or 6x37 for flexible drive, and take the factor of safety from the PSD data book, page number 9.1, choosing the particular class. For preliminary calculation, multiply the value by 2.5. And the N is the factor of safety. So this table is available in the page number 9.1. For flexible guys, jib cranes or ancillary applications, class 1, class 2 and 3, class 4. We have the value here, hoisting system of the flexible cranes where the jigs are supported by the ropes. We have the values 4, 4.5 and 5.5. The cranes and the hoist in general hoisting block 4.5, 5 and 6. And the all mining insulation. So the factor of safety is 10. And calculate the design load, factor of safety in load acting on the rope. Then select the particular grade of wire and take the tensile strength range from the table. So the table is given here. So for the given grade of wire, we can take the tensile strength 120 to 150 kilogram force per millimeter square, or 160 grade of wire, 160 to 190. So this we can select from the value based on the design load, tensile strength and the wire selected. Note down the diameter of the rope and the breaking strength from the data book, page number 9.4, 9.5 and 9.6. So referring to the page, we can take the value. And then we have to calculate the weight of the rope, diameter of the wire and the area of the rope. So rope construction, so based on that, weight may be 0.4 times d square, or wire diameter equal to 0.106 times diameter, and the area equal to 0.38 times diameter square. So using the formula, you can calculate, or refer to the data book, we can take the equation and calculate the weight, area and the diameter of the wire. Then calculate the stress on the wire rope. So the first direct stress due to the load to be lifted and weight of the rope. So F1 equal to capital W plus small w divided by A, kilogram force per centimeter square, where capital W is the weight to be lifted in kilogram force, small w is the weight of the rope in kilogram force, and A is net cross sectional area of the rope in centimeter square. And the bending stress due to the winding of the rope on the drum. So F2 equal to ER into dW by capital D in kilogram force per centimeter square, where ER is the modulus of elasticity or Young's modulus of the steel wire, which is normally taken as 0.8 in 10 power 6 kilogram force per centimeter square. So this value is also available in the page number 9.1. D is the diameter of the drum. So refer page number 9.1 for D by capital D by small d ratio, then we can calculate the capital D. And dW is the diameter of the wire in centimeter. And the stress due to the acceleration, F3 equal to capital W plus small w divided by A into A by G. So A is the acceleration, G is the acceleration due to gravity. So F3 is also in kilogram force per centimeter square. Where A is the acceleration of the rope, centimeter by second square. G is the acceleration due to gravity, which is 981 centimeter by second square. And the stress due to the starting, so we calculate F4 equal to W, capital W, weight to be lifted, small w, weight of the rope divided by A, multiplied by 1 plus into 1 plus 2 HER by F1 LG whole to the power 1 by 2 kilogram force per centimeter square, where H is the slack during the starting and L is the length of the rope. If the slack is not given, we can skip the calculation, F4 we can skip. And the effective stress of the rope during normal working, which is F1 plus F2, effective stress on the rope during the starting F4 plus F2, and effective stress on the rope during the acceleration is F1 plus F2 plus F3, and we have to calculate all the values, then calculate the factor of safety and compare the value given in the table. If the actual factor of safety is less than the permissible value, then the design is safe. So this is the final check for the rope design. Now we take one example from May 2010 question paper, example number 1. Select a suitable wire rope from 6 by 37 group to lift a maximum load of 10 kN through a height of 60 meter. The weight of the bucket is 2 kN. Maximum lifting speed is 2 meters per second, which is attained in 3 seconds. The drum diameter is 30 times the rope diameter and factor of safety is 6. So the data are given. So we write down load to be lifted W1, we take designate W1 equal to 10 kN, weight of the bucket W2 equal to 2 kN, total load equal to W1 plus W2 equal to 10 plus 2 equal to 12 kN. Wire rope is 6 by 13, height to be lifted 60 meter, maximum lifting speed V equal to 2 meters per second and time equal to 3 seconds. The drum diameter capital D is the 30 times of D. So, where D is the, small d is the diameter of the rope and factor of safety is given as n equal to 6. So, we calculate. So, the wire rope cross section is given 6 by 13. So, if we calculate the design load. So, design load is 2.5 into load to be lifted into the factor of safety. So, 2.5 into 12 into 6 equal to 180 kN, which is 180 divided by 9.81, 18.35 tons. Now, from the PSC data book, table page number 9.4. For a breaking strength of 20 tons and tensile strength of the wire 175 to 190 kilogram force per millimeter square. So, the 20 tons, how we selected 20 tons? Because we calculated 18.35 tons, we take the value for 20 tons. So, diameter of the rope equal to 18 millimeter and weight of the rope is 1.32 kilogram force per meter. So, the drum diameter we calculate, capital D equal to 30 times the small d. So, 30 into 18 equal to 540 millimeter. And from the PSC data book, page number 9.1, the useful cross-sectional area of the rope, A equal to 0.4 into pi by 4 d square. So, 0.4 into pi by 4 into 18 square equal to 101.79 millimeter square. Then, the wire diameter we calculate, DW equal to rope diameter divided by 1.5. into square root of number of strands, number of wires in each strand. So, 18 divided by 1.5 into square root of 66 into 37 equal to 0.8054 millimeter. So, the diameter of the wire. Then we calculate the effective load. Effective load equal to WD plus WB plus WR. So, WD is the direct load. We calculate the WR length, weight of the rope. WR equal to length of the wire into weight of the rope. So, the 60 into 1.32 equal to 79.2 kilogram force, which is 79.2 9.81. So, 776.95 Newton. And direct load equal to W plus WR. W is a total load including the rope and the load to be lifted. So, total load W plus WR 12,000 plus 776.95 equal to 12,776.95 kilonewton. And the bending load, to calculate the bending load, we require the Young's modulus, which is 0.8 into 10 power 6 kilogram force per centimeter square from page number 9.1. And bending the stress equal to E into DW by capital D into A. So, 0.8 into 10 power 6 into, we have to substitute in centimeter. So, 0.08054 divided by 54 into 101.79 into 10 power minus 2 in centimeter square. So equal to 1214.5 kilogram force. So in terms of Newton, 1214.5 into 9.81 equal to 11,914.67 Newton. And the acceleration A we calculate, so V2 minus V1 divided by T. So V1 equal to 0, initially it is 0. So 2 minus 0 divided by 3 seconds, time taken is 3 seconds. So it is 0.667 meter by second square. Then acceleration load WA equal to W plus WR divided by G into A. So 12,000 plus 776.95 divided by 9.81 into A equal to 0.667, which is 868.73 Newton. The effective load W equal to WD plus WB plus WA. So WD is the direct load, WB is the bending load, WA is the load due to the acceleration. So 12,776.95 plus 11,904.67 plus 868.73 equal to 25,560.35 Newton. So the actual factor of safety, braking load divided by effective load. So 20 tons, that is the braking load we have taken from the data book, 20 into 1000 into 9.81 to convert into Newton divided by 25,560.35, which is 7.67. So the maximum factor of safety for class 3 ropes is 5. The actual factor of safety is greater than 5, so the design is safe. So we stop here. So these are all the books I published in mechanical engineering subject, and I upload the video lectures of all the subject in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again in another video on the subject, on the same subject with additional problems on the wire rope. Until then, bye.